Hi guys, we are back with another cooking video, and tonight I'm really excited about this. We are going to make orange chicken, a mock orange chicken, but we're not using chicken, as you know, because this is alkaline Dr. Sabi inspired recipes. So that's what we're going to make tonight. And right now we're going to start off. Let me tell you what type of stuff you're going to need. And then the rest of the stuff I'll tell you as we go farther. You're going to need some oyster mushrooms. Here's some that I have here. This is how they look. I'll show you better how they look in camera. You're going to need garbanzo bean flour or spelt flour, whichever one you choose to fry them in. You're going to need some things for the orange ginger sauce. You're going to need some sesame oil. You're going to need some red pepper flakes, that's optional. Some onion powder, ginger powder, or fresh ginger. Some tamarind concentrate, that's what this looks like. There's other brands, but this one doesn't have anything in it but tamarind. And this is what you want. Let's see if we can zoom in here. Only tamarind. So you're going to want some of this. You're also going to need 3 oranges, sea salt, and then we'll get on to the rest of the stuff here soon. I'll let you know the rest of the ingredients. This is our first time making it, but I've already tried out the sauce. So the sauce I've already made to make sure it's going to work out. Oyster mushrooms, I already know how to make, you know, taste like chicken. So that's the next step. And you want to also have a rice base. So you can use wild rice or you can use quinoa. Over here, I've already got the quinoa going. If you're not sure how to make quinoa, I posted a video just before I uploaded this one, how to make the perfect quinoa in 20 minutes. So get you some quinoa going or some wild rice. Make sure you get it cooked because you're going to want it ready for your meal when you're done. So we're going to start off with a half a cup of garbanzo bean flour. Well, actually a cup. Let me get some more here.
I'm doing it in half a cup increments.
Yeah, we're going in half a cup increments here we're making a batter and, I want to make sure I have the right measurements for you because I usually eyeball everything. So tonight, make sure I have the right measurements and we won't be eyeballing. That's good, babe.
There we go. That was good.
So now we have a full cup of garbanzo bean flour.
Yep.
And then we're going to add some spring water to it.
We're just going to keep this around just in case we need to add more.
Yeah. So now we're going to add some spring water. I'll do a cup at a time. We're probably going to need another bottle. I don't know. Okay. Whoops. There's one cup. You're going to want to whisk this too. So, oh, this is going to be fun to get this out. All right. I got it, babe. All right. So, right now, this is a cup. We're going to season this batter after, but right now, we're going to try to get it right. I know. I kind of like it. Let me see. It's kind of runny.
Add some more flour.
Hang on, one cup to one cup.
Get this
I will. I just want to see how it's looking. Yeah, I'm going to make it a little thicker. So we're going to add another half a cup of flour.
Okay.
I'll give you the final measurement here when I'm done here, guys. So far, we've got one cup of garbanzo bean, one cup of water. We're going to add another half cup of garbanzo bean flour. So that's 1.5 cups of garbanzo bean flour to 1 cup water. Let's see if this makes the batter. What I'm looking for. Now it looks a little too thick, but maybe it's not. Maybe this is really what I need. But you know what? I have a feeling this isn't going to be enough, but maybe it will be. Actually, this looks pretty good. This looks like cake batter. You see that, guys? Hopefully you can see this action in there. Look at that.
Oh yeah.
All right, so we're going to add some seasonings to this.
Yep.
All right. And let's see. We're going to add some onion powder. You know, you just act like, you know, you're seasoning some chicken.
Always got to season the batter and the flour for chicken.
Half a tablespoon of onion powder. We're going to add a teaspoon of sea salt. And then we're going to add some cayenne.
Where's the cayenne?
It's up here. You know how I like the cayenne, guys? This is optional. That's about a fourth a teaspoon of cayenne. Let's see. And I usually don't put this on chicken, but I do put it on my oyster mushrooms when I fry them. So I'm going to use a half a tablespoon of oregano. All right. You can add more onion powder, more of the other stuff too, if you feel necessary, to season it to your liking with your seasonings.
Yep.
But the batter, we are at, again, I'm going to say it again.
1.5 cups of garbanzo bean flour to 1 cup of spring water.
Yes. Get it mixed in good. Scrape those sides. You know, I got a lot on the sides.
You know what it reminds me of?
Taste your batter too if you have to.
Batter.
Just to let you know, if you taste this batter, uncooked garbanzo bean flour tastes like grass, okay? We're just tasting it to see if it's salty enough, flavorful enough, but it's going to taste like grass, so be prepared, but it doesn't taste like that once it cooks.
The consistency reminds me of cornbread batter.
All right, that's good. That's good. Now, we got the batter ready. You're going to set that aside.
Yep.
And now you're going to need a dry batter. Another bowl. Get that little one over there. Okay. Mm-hmm. Yep. All right, now for the dry batter. Gonna need a cup.
1 cup. 1 cup.
All right, we're gonna need about a cup. All right, a cup of garbanzo bean flour. We're going to add some more flavor into this because you got to flavor everything.
Yeah, you got it. You always got to flavor your flour. If people do not flavor their flour when they make fried chicken,
half a tablespoon of onion powder. I'm going to do the same.
That's not good.
Yeah. I'm going to do the same. Teaspoon of sea salt.
Any cayenne to that?
Well, of course. Cayenne, optional. I'm adding a fourth a teaspoon of cayenne.
There you go.
And then we're going to add
some oregano.
Yep, and then half a tablespoon of oregano.
Oregano make everything taste good.
Oh, yeah. Well, we're kind of limited on our seasonings, you know, following the alkaline lifestyle, so we got to work with what we got. All right, so now let's give that a stir. I don't have a spoon over here, so I'm just going to give that a stir. Whoop.
Oh, she got backlash.
We have a lid for this, so that'll help when we shake it. Or, you know what, I can put it in a baggie.
Sure?
Yeah, Ziploc bag. That'll be even better. I would use a grocery store bag, but I think we're out.
Here we go.
All right, so we're going to put this in a bag to make it easier to shake them. Here we go. And I wore a black shirt. That was not a good move. Okay. We got that all ready. We're going to set that aside. Okay, so now we're going to clean the oyster mushrooms. We're just going to rinse them under some water and clean them real quick. That wetness is going to help the dry batter stick. We're going to clean them and season them. So get yourself a strainer. And then just run some cold water over them and clean them. Let me show you what they look like up close. You see that? They're fun. They're yummy. They taste a lot like chicken when you cook them in certain ways. Like today, we're going to use it to make it taste like chicken. Can you rinse that off for me too? Are they all dip? Is that it?
Yep, they're all wetted.
All right, guys, these are all rinsed off and clean and ready to go. You got a knife over there, honey?
Butter knife?
Nope, just a knife. So first we're going to, let's put that in there because it's dripping. We're going to season them. I'm going to season them right in here. That's how I always do it, and toss it. I'm going to do the same seasonings again. I'm going to You want to toss these as I season it? Mm-hmm. I'm going to season it with a half a tablespoon of onion powder. You toss it, and then I'll put more in. No, either hands. Just use your hands. Perfect. All right, let me put the rest in. All right, put that half a tablespoon of onion powder.
And don't worry, folks, my hands are clean. I washed them.
Yes.
I just did.
Even if he didn't. That's our choice.
Not going to wash them again.
All right, a teaspoon of sea salt. That's too much.
Half a teaspoon.
We're going to do half a teaspoon of sea salt. And I'm going to sprinkle some on. I want you to mix it in.
All right, stop.
All right. And then there's the rest. And then let me get me some cayenne going in there. Cayenne is optional. 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne. Make sure you don't have no cuts on your hands. If you're mixing something with your hands, it's got cayenne in it.
Oh, boy.
You're going to...
I learned the hard way.
Wish you hadn't. All right, we're going to sprinkle some oregano in there. Half a tablespoon of oregano. Again, use your favorite seasonings. Let me see.
Yes, I will.
I wonder if this has been in the camera at all this whole time. Well, I hope so, guys. All right, get the oregano, the rest of that. That was a half a tablespoon of oregano. Okay.
Okay, now.
Now, let that sit and marinate. I think our light shut off. Nope, it didn't. Thank goodness. You know what?
What?
Let me check this quinoa. Alright. Alright, guys, we'll be right back in a minute. We're going to go get our pans ready. Alright, guys, we're back. Alright, you're going to need you another saucepan because we're going to make the orange sauce and put your mushrooms aside so that they can marinate. Now, to make the orange sauce, we're going to need 3 oranges, but you're also going to need a mixer. So get you a mixer ready. Make sure that's in camera. Yep, okay. I got my mixer ready. And then I've already got my oranges cut, deseeded, and peeled. I leave the white stuff on here because actually it helps to thicken the sauce up. So, depending on how big your mixer is, I do have a big blender, but it's not going to work for this video. There's just no room. Mix these up. I'm going to have to do a little at a time. Whoop. Yep.
Man down.
All right, so just blend them up a little at a time. Whatever you need to do. If you got to use in a big blender, that's fine too. You want to plug this in here, babe?
Yes.
Once I get this plugged in, we'll get this mixed up. Again, that's 3 oranges, peeled and deseeded.
Thank you, baby. Mm-hmm. There you go.
All right, let's get them mixed. Now, I do want to let you know, your orange chicken sauce is not going to look orange by the time we're done. All right, dump that in the pan, but that's okay. It doesn't have to look orange. It really doesn't. We're going for flavor here. It's going to have a brown look to it. I am not concerned at all. I've already tasted it. It came out amazing. Okay, so there you go. There's your 3 oranges, blended and ready to go. There's that. There you are. Don't turn your heat on yet. Now, to this, we're going to add 1 teaspoon of tamarind concentrate. Do not add more than 1. It'll be too tangy. It won't work out right. Trust me when I say that. All right, 1 teaspoon. There you go. Here we go. Let me just rinse that one. All right, 1 teaspoon of tamarind concentrate. Next, you're going to need 1 teaspoon of sea salt. All right, 1 teaspoon of sea salt. It's still wet. Okay, 1 teaspoon of ginger powder, or you can use fresh ginger. I know not everybody has access to decent priced fresh ginger, so I wanted to make it easy. Just a pinch of crushed red pepper flakes. Really, just a pinch. Mine was a little under a pinch. You see that in there? Yes. Just a little pinch. I'm going to use 1/2 tablespoon of onion powder. Actually, you know what? That's a big thing. 1 tablespoon of onion powder. Sorry about that, not half, 1 tablespoon. And then we're going to use 1/2 tablespoon of sesame oil. Okay, now we're gonna give it a little stir before we turn on the heat. Alright, now we're going to add 1 tablespoon of agave. But I may add 2. Remember, we're going to do 1 tablespoon at a time. Hang on, I need my hubby to get the agave. Here's the big bottle here. Time to get a fresh bottle out. You guys, save your caps from your other bottles of agave if you like the pop caps. That's what we do. Alright, so I'm going to add 1 tablespoon at a time. You always want to taste it because sometimes you need less, sometimes you need more, because depending on how sweet the oranges ended up being. Give that a stir. We're going to turn the heat on now to medium high. It's got a little bit of an orange color, but the tamarind concentrate will, you know, is what darkens that. I'm going to give this a little taste. All right. It's just about perfect. We're going to add 1 more tablespoon of agave. So that's 2 tablespoons of agave. Mine isn't quite spicy enough, so you know what? I'm going to add a little bit more pepper flakes. I like it spicy. All right, we're going to cook this down and keep stirring it off and on because you don't want it to stick to the bottom. So we're going to cook it for 5 to 10 minutes. We're going to want it to thicken up a little bit more. Now this is optional, but this will help thicken it more. I'm going to add a teaspoon of sea moss powder. I will put a link below where you can get some sea moss powder. It might smell fishy, but it does not have a fishy taste. So we're going to add 1 teaspoon of that. Again, that is optional. If you don't have it, don't worry about it. Stir it in. And this will really help thicken it all up. But also, leaving your oranges the way I said will also, you know, give you that nice thickness you're hoping for as well. Once you put the sea moss powder in there, sometimes you got to get a whisk in there. Once in a while. Yeah, I'm going to get a little bit of a whisk going in there. Okay. And if you feel that it's too tangy for you, you just, all you gotta do is add more orange or less tamarind concentrate. All right, that's good. I'm gonna get this whisk in here, make sure everything is breaking up good. This is how it's looking so far. Let me get this spoon so you can see how thick it is. It's actually pretty good. It's not gonna be that gel looking orange sauce because we're making it from scratch and we don't have no nasty chemicals in there. This is gonna be real nice. Mm-hmm. All right, so let this cook on medium high for the next 5 to 10 minutes and then we're gonna take it off the heat. All right guys, now that that has cooked for 5 to 10 minutes, it's a nice little thickness here. You might not have to do it as long. Sorry. Let's see. Look at that. It's a nice thickness. So we're going to set that aside. All right. Let me move that over and put a lid on it. All right. Now we're going to work on the oyster mushrooms. Yeah. Right, here they go. What we're going to do is I'm going to chop some of them up, but some of them I'm going to leave just regular because my little one may not like the orange chicken. He's actually never had it, so I'm going to have some ready for just fried oyster mushrooms for him. But for us, we're going to cut some of them in chunks, so they're kind of, you know, like smaller chunks like orange chicken would be. Just small chunks, just like the same size as the orange chicken would have. You don't want them too big. You want to kind of make it similar to your favorite meal. We need another plate to put his on. See that? Nice small chunks. Let's see. Yeah, some of them I like to break apart for him. Sometimes if they're thinner, they have a really nice texture. So hold on, let me just do some for him real quick. Right. And that's it. Take that away. I'm going to go rinse my hands. We'll move on to the next part. We're going to need our batter again. Get our batter out. We're going to need our flour bag. We've got our oyster mushrooms sitting here. Now you're going to need a shallow pan for frying. Dr. Savvy does not recommend doing any deep frying. We're going to do a lower heat shallow fry. So I got it on a medium heat. Well, that's what I'm going to turn it on, is a medium heat. We're going to use some grapeseed oil. Just fill it up. Just maybe fourth of the way. You can add more if you need more as we go along, if you end up needing more. All right, let's turn this up to medium. All right, so we'll get your oil going. All right, so we'll be right back. We're gonna let the oil heat up and then we're gonna start battering these and getting them cooking. All right guys, we're back. Disregard the popping sound. I had a little bit of water in the pan. But after looking at this batter and after it sat for a little bit, we decided we're going to, it thickened up, like my husband said. We decided we're going to add 1/4 cup of spring water. You got that? All right. Actually, let me get the whisk. Hang on 1 second. We'll need it. I'll need it right back. Whisk that in. This should do it. So now we're at, what was that?
Is it
1 1/2 cups of garbanzo bean flour.
And 1 1/4 cup of water.
Okay, so 1 1/2 cups of garbanzo bean flour and 1 1/4 cup of water. Okay? Yes, that's perfect now.
Nice and agile.
Perfect. Have that, and I'll take the spoon back. All right, so you got your oil over here going on medium heat, shallow fry. Okay, all right, first we're going to I'm gonna need a little bit of room here. Let's see. We're gonna add some of these. We'll do my son's first, so he can eat first. We'll put them right in the bag. It's really simple. The flour will stick right to it because they were wet when you washed them. They've got their seasonings all over them. They're ready to go. Put them in the bag. All right. And give it a shake, however you want to do it. All right. There we go. Let's move this over here. Move this over here. Bring our batter in here.
So we'll go from dry to wet to pan.
Yes, take your dry one out. Dip it. You might need a spoon because your fingers will get really, really, you know, messy.
Give me the tongs while you do.
Drop them in the oil. Let me hang on here. I don't have the camera in the oil view. Let me figure this out a little bit here, guys. Now we can see everything kind of happening here. All right, I'll try to keep it all in view. Get your dough one. Drop. I like to drop a few in there. Or dough floured ones. All right. Cover them. Trying to get some of that excess off. I probably should have a fork, but I'm just going to do what we have. Drop it in the oil. Make sure you get it coated good.
All right, about to cook this one. I' 'll say what, 2 to 3 minutes each side?
No, not even. Just watch us fry them. It's really quick. You just look for the golden brown.
Yep, see how the edges look? That's when you want to flip them.
I'm not sure. I don't think they can see what you're doing because I'm kind of in the way here. We're going to need a plate with a paper towel on it. That one's a little dark. Wow, that got dark quick. See, you can do a lot. Your heat does not have to be up high. It's a medium heat. You let it heat up. Just give it time. Hopefully you can still see what I'm doing. Hang on, there's room for one more. Move this over a little bit. Get that right here. Alright, let me rinse my fingers. Give yourself a paper plate with some paper towels on it. Might have to move the quinoa. Okay, let me move that quinoa. You can move this quinoa.
Alright, here we go.
Get away from the fire. Alright, so get you a paper plate and some paper towels going. Mm. These don't take too long to cook. Remember, only a medium heat. And be gentle with them.
Turn back over.
Oh, you flipped them too soon, but that's okay.
This
I'm
one
gonna clean up a little bit.
I think this
so we don't have no fires.
Look at that.
Let me see. Nice.
This is what they look like afterwards.
And if you like a more crispy crust, you don't have to do a batter like us. You can just do them dry.
Yeah.
I'll show you how that looks too. I'll do a few like that.
About 2 to 3 minutes each side?
No. You know, I never time it. I just kind of just go on color. Let me see for a minute.
Yeah,
they're going to take a little bit. That one cooked really, really fast for some reason. I don't know why. It was the first one in the heat and, you know.
There we go.
looking pretty nice, I might say.
Honey, that smells good.
Yes, it does.
The lights are flickering. I hope the power don't go out. Well, if the power goes out, at least we can still record. Hopefully, we'll have enough light.
That's cool. It's nice and golden brown.
Yeah.
Look at that bad boy.
We can go darker, too. You
want them to go darker?
Yeah.
Okay. Drop back down. Bloom.
Get them nice and golden brown. If you grab them from the sides when I do it and then flip it, you won't mess up the batter. So I know you never made these. I'm the one that usually made them.
Yeah.
So it's just like making chicken, it really is. Let me see, they look about, I think they look about, well, not that one. That one looks good. Let's see if we can get it in on camera here. See that? Looks nice. Put it over here on a plate. I like to give them a little squeeze because it gets them off some excess oil. See that one there? Nice and crispity, crunchity. Wait, there we go. And then what I'll do is I'll show you some of the, just the floured ones. How they come out. Alright, keep them back there on your pan. I'm going to get some more. Get them in there. I think there's a few more. He's not going to eat all that, but you can have what's left over for lunch tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Here, we'll do a couple of his, just the dry ones, and not put in the batter, so you can see the difference. Oh, there only was a couple in there. Well, I guess that's all you're going to see. All right, guys, the ones that were dry, and they didn't go in the batter, this is how they turned out. Kind of hard to show you, but let's see if we can get a close-up here. There you are. So that's how they turned out. You can do them that way, it is completely fine. Alright, so now what I want you to do before we put our next little bit in here, get another pan going here, okay? I got a pan going over here, and you're going to oil it. Where's my oil, babe? Hold on, guys. Oil it and add some red peppers. This is optional, but it's going to taste really good in the dish. Some oil going in there, and you just season them with some sea salt, cayenne, onion powder, however much you like. So get your red peppers in there and get them going. They'll be really quick. And also have off to the side some green onion, however much you like, because that's going to go on the final dish when it's done. All right, so get you your peppers going, and I'm going to eyeball it. We're going to put a little bit of some cayenne in there. I'm actually not going to put onion powder. I'm just going to put a little sea salt. And a little bit of sea salt. That's it. That's all I'm adding. Add what you want. You don't have to add anything at all. So let them cook down, and then once they're cooked, set them aside, because you're going to put that in your dish. Alright, back over here, and let's get some more of these oyster mushrooms going.
see. Hopefully my batter's in the camera. Yeah, let him eat what he can. Whatever he leaves over, you can have for lunch. Try not to stir it as much as you want to. Just don't. Just coat them with your spoon. Get them in here in the frying. These are our little chunks. These are going to be for the orange chicken dish. All right, we'll let them cook up. And get some more in the batter. Get them ready so we can get this dish going fast here. If you don't have somebody helping you in the kitchen, don't forget to keep an eye on your peppers. I am stirring them right now. A little stir, let them cook up. Don't forget about them. Bring them back over here. All right, we're going to cut the video short here, and then we're going to be right back so that we can save my memory space for the rest of the video. We're going to put batter the rest of these, get them in there cooking, and then we'll be back as they're almost done. Keep an eye on those peppers. Hi, guys. We're back. These ones are done. We'll take them out and put the rest of them in. Peppers are just about done. They're still cooking. Alright guys, we're back. These ones are done. We're going to add the rest this time. Hopefully that's the rest. It looks like it's going to be. See, you don't have to have meat.
Nope.
That is a myth. Look up the dangers of meat. No, look up Google. The dangers of eating meat. And for men, if you like your sex life, you're really going to want to Google the dangers of eating meat.
Those are the lies that your physicians be telling you, that you need meat and protein.
They are done. We're just going to set them aside. Oh. Put them aside. Don't forget to turn the heat off. Let's get back over here. What's going on? Good, move that up.
Are you using any?
Nope. Alright, I'm going to keep flipping these and let them finish cooking, and I'll be back when they're done. Alright guys, we're at the end here. Our meal is about done. These are done. Put them over here. Now, if you decide to not use the batter and just do the dry batter, I gotta tell you something. When you do that, you take them out after they're done cooking and you let them sit on the paper towel like this. Once they're all done and they've sat for a couple of minutes, you put them back in the oil and fry them up real quick again, because this will solidify the coating and help it stick better when you go to put all of the orange sauce all over it.
Yep.
Okay, so now we're going to move this out of the way. All right, now we're going to put our orange ginger sauce over here on the heat. It doesn't really need to be heated, but okay, we got our sauce going here. Now to the sauce, we're going to throw in our red peppers and half of the green onions. There's a half a cup here, so there's half of them. All right, you're going to want a spoon because you're going to want to fold the rest. Well, this will work. Now we're going to take our chicken, well, our mock chicken, our fried oyster mushrooms. Let's just fold them in, babe.
Okay.
Yeah. Did I lose one?
Yeah, you're losing a couple.
All right, fold it in. Be gentle with it. Alright, ready for some more?
Yeah.
Now it might be too many. Looks like I might have too many, but that's okay. You can put them aside for lunch the next day. Here, fold them in, see if they work. Just double the recipe if you have a big family. We're only feeding the three of us, so there's always going to be leftovers. My husband Takes a lot to lunch, so we always make extra. More?
Yeah.
You sure? Because we want it a little runny for the rice.
No, I don't think
so. All right, let them see. See how that is? That looks good. Here, put it up closer here. That looks really good. All right, we're going to leave the rest of these to the side for him for lunch or whatever. And we're not going to add more because we want to have it a little bit, just a little bit of extra sauce in there for when we put it over the quinoa. Now we're going to plate it. I'm going to show you how we're going to do that. All right, so here we go. I'm going to need you some quinoa.
Quinoa.
No, I don't. Thank you, Sean. Well, it's a little spoon, but it'll do. Oh. All right, normally I wouldn't recommend doing it this way, but... All right, so you get your quinoa in there. Yeah, don't tip it. All right. Remember, guys, I gotta make my plate look pretty for the picture. Don't worry about it if you're eating it. So you got you some quinoa there. Now we're gonna add, we're gonna need a better spoon. No. Hold on, guys. Need a bigger spoon. I got one here. Alright, so now we're going to get some of our mixture here. See if we can get it in camera here. Alright. Get you some of your orange chicken. Put that right over the top.
Y'all look heavenly.
Just like that. Oh, and some sesame seeds. I almost forgot. We'll have sesame seeds if I can find them because, like I said, I almost forgot. All right. You got your little plate made. You put you some sesame seeds on top, but you can also put them right in the mix. Put you some green onions on there. Get them all over. And there you have it, guys. We have orange chicken.
My orange chicken.
I really hope you enjoy this. Let's see if we can get a side view of it. Put it up here a little bit. There you go. Orange chicken. It's our first time making it, so we'll have to have hubby give it a taste test. See what he thinks. Here, let's get you a little bit of quinoa and a little piece of chicken. Okay. Oh, wait. Let's get you a green onion out here. There you go. Here, take that first. Mm. All right. All right, he's testing it out.
Mm. That's good.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, there we go. Oh, another good meal. Hubby likes it. Thank you, guys. I hope you enjoy this. Please let me know. I would love to hear what you think of the recipes after you make them.
Yep, like, comment, subscribe.
Yes, please do like, comment, and subscribe. And as always, I will link any of the ingredients I can down below in the description box so that you can find it online if you don't have it at your local food store. And also, don't forget our Facebook page for just the recipes called Dr. Stabby's Inspired Recipes. is linked at the bottom in the box as well. So, see you in the next video. Bye.